This teaching you're about to listen to was preached by Jegede Sunday E and recorded live at God's Family Bible Church, Trinidad. Jegede Sunday E is the General Coordinator of Errands of Revival Ministries and the School of Discipleship. He is also the Missionary Pastor of GFBC Trinidad under the leadership of Pastor Abolaji Akimbo, the General Overseer of God's Family Bible Church Worldwide, Palm Coast, Florida. Listen and be transformed.
As we continue in our intercession tonight, all right, I just want to challenge you tonight to begin to see as the winner, all right? Let's pray. Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Lord, because this is our year of glorious changes. It is our year of stardom, our year of glory, our year of shining. It's our year of excellence. Things are not remain, are not allowed to remain the same, Father. Father, we thank you. We are marching forward into your will, fulfilling your plan and purpose for our life. And tonight, Father, we open our heart and we receive your word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. And I want someone to shout a big amen. Amen. Very quickly, I want to speak on what I call the winner's perspective. The winner's perspective. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The winner perspective. All right. So what do I mean by that? I mean, now listen, pay attention. When we say your perspective in life, we are talking about your mental view, all right? We are talking of your position, your outlook. We are talking of your point of view. In other words, when I say perspectives, I mean your mindset, your mentality. You understand? I mean the way that your the mental attitude that you have that actually determine how you interpret, how you see things, how you respond to life situation. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Now, simply put, when I say perspective, I'm talking about your way of looking, your way of looking at things, all right? Your way of seeing things, the way you see things, the way you interpret things. Do you understand what I'm talking about? The way you think about something, all right? The way you see or regard a situation. So when I say my perspective, I'm simply saying the way I see things, the way I interpret things, all right? The way I look at things, all right? That is my perspective in life. And pay attention to this. Pay attention tonight before we continue our prayer. Now listen to me. There is a vast difference. There's a great difference between the way the winner see and the loser see.
Yeah.
Do you understand? So the winner perspective is different from the loser perspective.
Yeah.
There's a great difference between the way a success think and the way a failure think. Do you understand?
Yeah.
There's a big difference between the way a victor think, that is a champion, and a victim, the way they think.
Yeah.
Alright? So there's a vast difference between the perspective of the winner and the loser. And do you know something? You are a winner. Let someone say, I am a winner in Christ Jesus. And so it is time for us to begin to see as a winner.
Yeah.
All right? It is time for us to begin to process things in our mind as a winner. It is time for us to begin to cultivate and develop the mindset of a winner, the mentality of a winner.
Yeah. Yeah.
It is time for us to begin to see from the point of view of a winner in life. Now listen to me. Pay attention to me tonight. You see, now your reality, your perception, your perceptive is your reality. Now pay attention. Now, it is not the way things are that really matter. What really matters is the way that I see things.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Okay.
Do you understand? Now, you see, the challenge, the situation you are going through, that is not really the big deal. Do you know the big deal? How you interpret it?
Yeah.
The big deal is, from what point of view are you seeing it? How do you see it? Do you know why? Because the way you see your situation, the way you see yourself, the way you see your challenges, that is the way you are going to relate with it. That is the way you are going to deal with it. That is the way you are going to respond to it. Do you understand what I'm talking about? That is why same things can happen to two people, and they will react to it, they will respond to it differently. Do you know why? Because of the way they see it. Because of the way they view it. Alright? Because of the way they interpret it in life. There is a way a winner see. There's a way a champion see. There's a way a success think. There's a way the rich think. You understand what I'm talking about? It is different from the way the poor think. And do you know something? I want to challenge you. In Christ Jesus, you are already a victor. You are already a winner. You are already more than conqueror. Are you paying attention? So if we are not seeing the victory, if you are not seeing the prosperity, because we are blessing God, then we need to change the way we see things. We need to change our perspective. We need to change our mindset. We need to change the way we regard this. We need to change the way we see ourselves. Do you understand what I'm talking about? You see, the Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 5, 4 and 5, the Bible says, whatever is born of God overcomes the world. Let some say, I'm born of God. I am an overcomer. So you see, being born again is a change of status, alright? It changes us from being a loser. It changes us from being a victim. It changes us from being a cursed people, alright? And it brings us to the class of Christ, to the position of Christ. Because when you are born again, you become an heir of God and a joint heir with Christ. You become one spirit with God. Everything that is true of Jesus is true of us. Do you understand what I'm talking about? The Bible says, whatsoever is born of God, if you are born of God, if you believe in Christ, you are no overcomer. Do you understand? Not that you are going to be, you're already a winner. You're already a champion. Not that you are going to have it, you're already blessed in Christ Jesus. Do you understand? But pastor, why am I not seeing it? Why is that not my reality? Now, listen to me. That is your spiritual reality. Everyone in Christ Jesus is an overcomer. Amen. Everyone in Christ Jesus is more than a conqueror. Amen. Everyone in Christ Jesus is a champion. Amen. Everyone in Christ Jesus is blessed. Amen. Do you understand what I'm talking about? But do you know something? That is what we call spiritual reality. They are true in the spirit. But that may not be your natural physical reality. It may not be your day-to-day experience if you don't start thinking that way. If you don't stop the way you see yourself and regard yourself, and begin to regard yourself just as God says that you are. Is somebody paying attention to what I'm talking about? And tonight I just want us to, we're going to look at a passage of the Bible. And what I just want you to see is, I want you to see the way the winners see. And I want you to see the difference or the differences between the way the winners see, that is the winner perspective, the way they think, the way they deal, regard situation, their mindset, their mentality, the way they interpret life challenges, and the way the loser interprets it. Alright? And the reason is because in this new year 2019, I want every member of this job to begin to think like the winner that we are in Christ Jesus. To begin to think like the champion that we are in Christ Jesus. To begin to think as the blessed that we are in Christ Jesus. Are you ready with me tonight? Are you ready to learn? Alright, so let's go to Numbers chapter 30. It's quite a long passage, alright? So we just go through it. So how do winners see? What is the winner perspective? How do winners interpret things? How do champions, how do they view things? How do they regard things? So in Numbers chapter 13, alright, the children of Israel, they were close to Canaan, the promised land, and then the Lord spoke from verse 1. The Lord spoke to Moses saying, send men to spy out the land of Canaan. In other words, let them go and view it, alright? Which I'm giving to the children of Israel from each tribe of their father, you shall send a man, everyone a leader among them, all right. Let's not say leader among them. It matters how a leader see, all right. So leader, minister, pay attention tonight. Now, so from verse 3 now, so Moses sent from the wilderness of Paran, according to the command of the Lord, all of them, men who were the heads of the children of Israel, all right. So each leader from each tribe, we have 12 tribes, so 12 men, they went to spy, to see, to view the Canaan land that God is giving to them. From verse 4, now these were the names from the tribe of Reuben, Shammah the son of Zakkur, all right, and all that. Let's jump to verse 25, all right. So that tells us all the names of the people that went. I want you to pay attention. So 12 men, all right, are you with me? 12 men, 12 leaders, they went to spy the land of Canaan, the promised land, the land flowing with milk and honey, the land that God has promised. In other words, they went to check out their inheritance, what God has promised them, alright? So they traveled for 40 days, alright? And when they returned, look at what happened from verse 25, and the Bible said they returned from spying out the land after 40 days. Now I want you to pay attention to their different views now. Are you with me? Now, 12 of them, they saw the same thing. Are you paying attention? They went, they were on the same assignment. They went to the same place, the same Canaan land. They went to the same city. Are you paying attention? And they saw the same people. They saw the same thing. They experienced the same thing. But the way they interpreted it, the way they view it, differ. All right. So let's see now. So we're going to see these people that went to spy. Now, some of them saw like winner. Some of them saw like losers. Are you paying attention?
Yes.
Now, so we have two categories, two classes now. One has the winner perspective. The other one has the loser, the victim perspective. One has the victor perspective. The other one has the loser or the victim perspective. So let's see from verse 26 now. So now when they departed and came back to Moses, so two of them returned, and to Aaron and all the congregation of the children of Israel in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh, they brought back word to them and to all the congregation and showed them the fruits of the land. So they brought the fruits of the land. When you really hear the verse, the Bible says even one cluster of grape, two of them had to carry it with a bowl. Alright, the land was so rich, the land was so fertile. Alright, but pay attention from verse 27 now. These are 10 men speaking now. So they told him, that's it, they told Moses, said, we went to the land where you sent us. It truly flows with milk and honey, and this is the fruit. In other words, it's not that when you go to that place, you see milk and honey flowing, all right? No, but they are saying it is a blessed land. It is rich land. All right, very fertile. Now, but pay attention. Now, they say, it was just as God said it. It was a blessed land, all right? In other words, it was good. It was good. All right, are you with me? They say it was good. This is the evidence of this is a cluster of grapes. One man cannot carry it. Even two men cannot. They have to use a pole between them to carry. But pay attention. Verse 28. Alright. But they said nevertheless. Let's not say nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
Now the word nevertheless means but.
But.
Alright. That's verse 28. Verse 28. Numbers 13. Just go to verse 28 please. Nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong. The cities are fortified, very large. Moreover, we saw the descendant of Enoch there. Now, listen to this. Now, the land was good. It was a land flowing with milk and honey. But, now, you see, when you see somebody, when God asks them to do something, and they put bets there, well, what the Lord said is good, but, now, that is already a loser mindset, all right? Is somebody paying attention? All right. Now, so, they said, never, it was really good, but there's a problem, all right? There's a difficulty, all right? Even though it is good, we are not able to take it, all right? That is the way the loser, that's the way they think, that's the way they speak. Is somebody paying attention? That is their perspective, all right? So, you have to be careful when God promise you something. When God puts an idea in your mind, somebody paying attention. When God says, go ahead and do something, don't put any buts there. Somebody paying attention. All right? Don't put any buts. Go all the way. Go all the way. All right. So, verse 29, they said, the Amalekite dwell in the land of the south. That's verse 29. The Hittite, the Jebusite, the Amorite dwell in the mountain. The Canaanite dwell by the sea and along the bank of the Jordan. All right. Verse 30 now, the Caleb quieted them. He hushed them. He said, oh, shh, keep quiet. There are many of our friends that we need to say the same thing to them, all right? Because whenever they come, they're always talking of the bet. Well, what you said is good, but where are you going to get the money, all right? Oh, that business is good, but who's going to buy from you? People like that, you need to say, hush. Hush your mouth, keep quiet. Alright, so that's what Caleb said. Caleb quieted the people before Moses. And he said, let us go at once and take possession, for we are well able to overcome. That's how I say we are well able. Alright, but verse 31 now. But the men who had gone up with him said, we are not able. Now begin to see, 12 of them, they saw the same thing. How come 10 people say, we are not able? The two others say, we are well able, all right? So you see, they didn't see the same way. They didn't interpret, even though they saw the same thing, they did not interpret it in the same way. They had different mindset, all right? Okay, so they said, no, verse 31, but the men who had gone up with him said, we are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. And they gave the children of Israel a bad report of the land, with their spoilers, saying, the land through which we have gone to spy is a land that devours its inhabitants. Can you imagine? These were the same people that said, it was a land who flowed with milk and honey. So which one do we believe? All right. And do you know something? They said, the land devours its inhabitants. inhabit. How is that possible? They just listed all the people they saw there. The Canaanite, the Jebusite, the Hittite. So how come the land has not devoured them? That is the way the loser think. All right, that's the way they speak. And all the people whom we saw, they were men of great stature. Verse 3, the last verse. There we saw giants. The giant, descendant of Anak, came from the giant. And we were like grasshoppers in our own side. And so we were in their side. All right, before we move on, let's quickly draw a contrast between the perspective of the winner and the perspective of the loser. Pay attention. 10 people, now 12 of them, they were spying, they were sent to the land of Canaan. 10 of them came back with a bad report, all right? And 2 of them, Joshua and Caleb, they came back with a good report, all right? So let's see why the difference. They were in the same place. They saw the same thing. Somebody paid attention. They had the same fruits, all right? They experienced the same thing. But then, how come they interpreted it differently? It shows that their mind, that is what we call mindset. All right? Their mentality. It simply means the way they think, or the way Joshua and Caleb think, is different from the way other people think. Somebody paying attention? All right. So I wanted to see the winner perspective now. All right? Now, the winners always see themselves as well able to deal with and to overcome any life challenge. Somebody paying attention? Now, that is the winner perspective. See Joshua and Caleb. Caleb quite telling me, keep quiet. We are well able. Oh, there are giants there. We are well able to overcome them. The land before is habitat. We are able to overcome it. The Canaanites are there. We are well able. All right. Men of great stature. We are well able. They had a mighty war. We are well able.
Yes.
Now that's the way in this year 2019, I want you to begin to think and to begin to speak. Yeah. It doesn't matter what comes your way. This year 2019, you are well able. Somebody paying attention? You are well able. You want to start a business? Don't put any bugs, whatever obstacle, you are well able to overcome. Somebody paying attention? Yes. Whatever the Lord has put in your heart, whatever ideas, business idea, whatever assignment, I want you to look at yourself and say, I am well able. Do you know why? Because Christ dwells in you. Yeah. He that dwells in you, that lives in you, is greater than any of the world there. Because in Christ you are more than conqueror. Yeah. Somebody paying attention? Yeah. You are full of power by the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God dwells in you. So the winners always see themselves as well able to deal with any life challenge.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what the obstacle say. We say, oh yes, this is the obstacle. We are well able. We will deal with it. We will overcome it. We will go beyond it. That is the way the winner see.
Yes.
But look at the loser. We are not able. We are not able. All right. Can you look at that?
Yes.
Oh yes, Pastor. I know God has put in my hand to start a business. I have the plan. But you know, Pastor, I don't think I can do it. Now, you are not... That's somebody that is speaking from a loser perspective.
Yeah.
Losers always see themselves as not well able. Yeah. Is somebody paying attention? Yeah. Let me tell somebody, say, you are well able to do whatever God calls you to. So I want you to know that you are well able. Don't ever think like loser. They always think that, well, this is too much for me. No. No. For the winners, nothing is too much. Nothing is beyond them. Is somebody paying attention? Now, look at this. Look at this now. The losers, all right? Those ten men that went to spy the land. Do you know what they saw there? Now, when they look at the land, all right? Do you know that they focus their eyes on the men of great stature?
Uh-huh.
Is somebody paying attention to what I'm talking about? Do you know that they saw the giants, all right? Do you know that they saw the obstacle? All that they say is, why they will not be able to take over the land? That is the way the loser see, all right? The loser always see their challenge and their opposition as giant. They make a giant out of it. Can you look at it now? I want you to see chapter 14. Now, the same giant that 10 men were saying, oh, we saw men of great stature. They were giants and we were like grasshopper in their side, in our side. Said, we are just so little, so small. But look at Joshua. Verse 14, chapter 14, please. Can you go to chapter 14? Quickly, look at what Joshua said. Now, they just described the men they saw there, but look at how Joshua and Caleb described them, all right? Now, chapter 14, quickly, let me read from verse 5. All right? Now, so, okay, let's go to six because of time. So, but Joshua, the son of Nun, and Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, who were among those who had spied out the land, they tore their clothes. When other people were saying, we are not able, let's go back to the to where we came from. Can you imagine? They were so close to the promised land, so close to what God promised them. They said, well, because of giant, because of the obstacle, let's just turn back to Egypt. Now, so Joshua and Caleb, they tore their clothes. And look at what they said to them in verse 7. And they spoke to all the congregation of the children of Israel, saying, the land we passed through to spy out is an exceedingly good land.
Yes.
Now, and look at it. Verse 8 and 9. If the Lord delight in us, he will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land which flow with milk and honey. Only do not rebel against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land. For they are what? Our bread.
Yes.
Let's not say our bread.
Our bread.
Now, the loser said they are giants.
Yes.
Do you understand? Now, they saw the same people. Now, some describe them as giants, men of great stature. And they said, we are like grasshopper, like a hand, little hand, before them. But look at how the winner described them. They were talking about the same thing. The winner described them as what? Our bread. Their protection has departed from them. The Lord is with us. Do not fear them. Can you see?
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
When a winner is going or maybe on an assignment, is pursuing something, and then an obstacle just pop up, a challenge just come. Do you know what? A winner does not see that challenge as a giant.
No, no.
Do you understand? He sees it as something to tackle. Just like I said, that's nothing. Don't worry, I'm going to get over that. I'm going to get through with that. That is the way I want you to begin to see and to begin to think in this year 2019.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what show ups on your way, as you are pursuing God's plan and purpose for your life, as you are carrying out what God has put in your heart, don't see it as giants. Is somebody paying attention? Don't see it as something stronger than you. There is nothing that comes against you that is stronger than you. Joshua says, be our bread.
Right.
In other words, you know what do you do to bread? You don't fight for bread, you just swallow it up. Right. That's what he said. Other people say, hey, they are giants. Look at their stature, look at their muscle, they are big, they are thick. He said, are we seeing the same thing, really? Because what I'm seeing is just a piece of bread. What I'm seeing is just people with no strength.
With no strength.
Now listen to this. Many a time, that's what the devil show. The devil brings up something to you and say, can you see this is insurmountable? This is big. This is too much. You can't deal with this. You can't take this anymore. You can't handle that. That's a lie. That's a lie. Somebody paying attention, you are stronger than whatever the devil brings your way. Let's not say, I am stronger than any challenge or situation. So you see, can you see the way the winner see? The winner see giants as bread, alright? But the loser, they see hands as giants. Somebody paying attention? And that is where they are always perplexed with fear. Now look at the last thing. Look at the last thing before we pray. How do winners see? How do losers see? All right. Now look at this thing. Now the winner always see whatever challenge, whatever obstacle that come up on their way as an opportunity. Somebody pay attention. As an opportunity to advance. As an opportunity to demonstrate, to reveal their potentials, who they are. All right. But the loser always see every challenge that comes their way as an excuse to quit. You understand? As an excuse to stop. All right. Now maybe when a challenge comes, maybe God asks you to go to a place. All right. And maybe you want to start a business. You write a business proposal. Alright, and they say, oh no, this is not good enough. Alright, a loser will say, well, that is it. Alright, that's it. And that they drop it, they forget about the business plan. But you know what a winner will say? The winner will say, alright, do you want me to go back and work more on it? Alright, you want me to develop it better? Now, and if they say no, the winner will try another place. Is somebody paying attention?
Yeah.
The winner does not see challenge or obstacle as an excuse to quit. Alright, it becomes a motivation to go forward. Is somebody paying attention? And that's the way this year 2019 I want you to see. Whatever challenge, whatever obstacle, don't take that as an excuse to stop. Don't take that as an excuse to quit. Do you know these people? When they got so close to where God was taking them, and they were thinking, let's go back, let's come back, let's make a leader, let's make a U-turn. That is the way they lose that thing. Whenever they see a brick, whenever they see an obstacle, they want to make a U-turn. They want to turn back. This year 2019, don't turn back. You need to go ahead and go for whatever God has promised you. When they say no, say, I'm coming back again. Is somebody paying attention? I'm going to try again. When you fail, rise up again and say, I am still going to try again. That is the winner's thing. win. That is the winner perspective. And listen to me, that is the way we can walk in the reality of everything that Christ has made available for all. And so this year, 2019, it doesn't matter the challenge. It doesn't matter your past experience. Is somebody paying attention? Don't take that as an excuse. Don't take that as an opportunity to quit, all right? Now, you see, that's the way they lose that thing. Every obstacle they see, that's a signpost that says stop. Do you understand what I'm? But that's not true. That's not true.
Right.
We now don't see obstacle as a signpost to stop. They see it as an invitation to show who they really are. They stop. They are made all. They say, well, that's the world. I'm going to go over it. All right? If I can't go over it, I'm going to dig under it. If I can't do that, I'm going to pull it down. That is the way the winner thing. That is the winner perspective. And do you know what? In this year, 2019, that's exactly the way I want us to begin to think. So how do we cultivate the winner perspective before we begin to pray? Now listen to this. The winner perspective is simply God's perspective. All right, the way God sees things, the way God deals with things, the way God views things, the way God regards things. There's a way God regards situations. Somebody pay attention, and that is the way the winners also regard situations. Now, God's perspectives are clearly revealed by Christ Jesus. You know, when Jesus was on earth, the way he saw things was different from the way the disciples and other people around him saw something. Now, take for instance, when I think in John chapter 11, when Lazarus was dead, are you with me? Lazarus was already dead for days. And Jesus said, let's go and wake him up. He was talking about a dead man.
Yeah.
But he didn't see him as a man. You know, to us, when a man is dead, all hope is lost. But Jesus said, I'm going to wake him up, all right? Can you see the way he saw, the way he thought, the way he interpreted that is completely different? There was a time, I think, in the book of Matthew chapter 14, all right? About 5,000 women and not counting men. Not counting women and children. They gathered together. And Jesus called his disciples and said, give them something to eat. And Philip said, what are you talking about? We only have 5 loaves and 2 fish, all right? To them, that was nothing. To them, that cannot do anything. But Jesus said, don't worry. Just bring it. Now, and he multiplied. And the Bible says, after the effect, they see how many 12 baskets left over. Can you see the way Jesus saw things? The way Jesus approached challenges and situations is completely different from the way the disciples did. And this year, 2019, know to develop winner perspective is for you to begin to see, to begin to view things, judge things, interpret it the same way that Jesus Christ will do. Alright? So, when I find myself in a situation, in a challenge, the question I ask myself, if Jesus were to be in this situation, how would Jesus see this situation? How would Jesus view this situation? What would Jesus be thinking? Is somebody paying attention? How would Jesus respond? How would Jesus interpret this? That is the right perspective. That's the right part. That is the way you need to think. But Pastor, how will I know that? Get into the world. The word of God is God's perspective. Now listen to this. When you open up your heart to the world and you take time to read the word and let the word of God renew your mind, do you know what? You begin to think the world. You begin to think as God would think. You begin to think as Jesus would think. Is somebody paying attention? When they say, oh, that's dead, that is over, you say, it's not yet over. It's not yet over. Because that is the way Jesus would speak. Oh, when they say, this is not, you know, he said, don't worry, I'm going to pray over it, the blessing of God is going to come upon it, and God is going to multiply it, and that we should think it's not enough, it's going to be more than enough. That is the way Jesus would speak. That is the way Jesus would think. Alright? When you tell Jesus is not enough, Jesus said, don't worry, bring it. I'm going to multiply it. Alright? Now, Jesus will always think in line with the world. And do you know something? Now, developing the winner perspectives is you also renewing your mind with the truth of God's word. Is you beginning to see things, beginning to view things, beginning to think, beginning to judge and interpret life situation the same way as God will do. Is somebody paying attention? And that starts from me seeing myself the way God sees me. How do you see yourself? How do you view yourself? Alright? In spite of your disappointment, of your failure, in spite of your shortcoming, of your weaknesses, how do you still see yourself? Alright? Do you still see yourself as God sees you? In the world, in the sight of God, the Bible says you are an overcomer. Alright? And that cannot change. Alright? Because that is settled already in heaven.
Yeah.
You are an overcomer. Alright? You begin to see yourself like that. I overcome. I'm a champion. I'm a victor in Christ Jesus. The Bible says you are already washed. All right, 1 Corinthians 6:11. You are washed. You are sanctified. You are justified. That is the way you see yourself. Don't see yourself as an unclean person. Don't see yourself as an unholy person. Is somebody paying attention? Now, in the sight of God, Colossians 1:21-22, the Bible says you are holy. You are blameless. You are above reproach in the sight of God. That is the way you see yourself. Don't call yourself a wretched sinner. You are a saint of God. Now, so the way you see yourself, pay attention that this is important. The way you see yourself is the way you deal with life situation. Yeah.
That's right.
If I see myself as a sinner, all right, do you know what? It will be easy for me to fall into every temptation, all right, because I already see myself as a slave of sin. But when I say no, I may have a struggle with a sin, but I'm not a sinner anymore. I am washed, I am justified, I'm sanctified, I'm a child of God, full of the Holy Ghost. I have a new nature. Do you know something? I'm going to overcome temptations, all right. Amen. Somebody pay attention. When I see myself as blessed in Christ Jesus, all right, do you know what? I'm going to think like that. I'm going to act like that. I'm going to speak like that. All right? But when I see that, well, maybe I see have some family cause, generational cause. Do you know something? You're going to act like that. You're going to think like that. When something happens, you say, well, this is like a cause in my family. All right? No, friend. That means you are not seen as God sees. You are not seeing yourself as God sees you. Alright? Winner perspective is God's perspective. You need to begin to see yourself just as God sees you. Yeah. So I need to go into the world and find out, how does God see me?
Yeah.
When God look at me, what does God see? And the scripture clearly revealing that when God look at you, he sees more than conqueror.
Yeah.
When God look at you, he sees a son bought and redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
Yeah.
When God sees me, he sees a righteous person. Is somebody paying attention?
Yeah.
When God sees me, he sees an overcomer. When God look at me, he sees someone that is blessed. When God sees me, he sees someone that is a winner in life. And you know something? That is the way I see myself. That is the way you need to see yourself. And when you begin to see yourself like that, then you begin to see situation and life challenges and opposition just as God sees them. So you see, winner perspective is you seeing through the lens of the word of God. Is somebody paying attention? Now you see, this 2019, I don't want us to begin to see ourselves through our past experiences. Don't see yourself as the people of the world sees you. Is somebody paying attention? No. See yourself through the lens of the word of God. Not through the lens. Some of us, we see ourselves through the lens of our friend. Oh, my friend said this is who I am. And that means that is who I am. What's that, friend? What does God say you are?
Yes.
So see through the lens of the word of God. Let me tell someone, say, from today, begin to see through the lens of God's word. Begin to see yourself as God sees you. Is somebody paying attention to me? Now, as we rise up to pray, let's look at Psalm chapter 2. The book of Psalm chapter 2, all right? I wanted to see how God sees, all right? When opposition comes, when enemies gather against God, I wanted to see how God sees them, how God sees challenge, how God sees opposition. The book of Psalm chapter 2 from verse 1. Why do the nations rage and the people plot a venting? Let's not say a venting. So when the enemies of God are plotting, all right, God see what they are plotting as useless, as vain. Is someone paying attention? All right. Now look at the next verse. The kings of the earth, they set themselves together. In other words, they join hands together, and the ruler, they take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed. All right. So all the kings of the earth, this is a messianic psalm, they gather together against God and say, we don't want to have anything to do with God. Look at verse 3 now. Alright, now, and they say, let us break their bones in pieces and cast them where they are come from. In other words, we don't want to have anything to do with God. Let's rebel against God, alright? But look at how God sees them. Look at how God viewed them, alright? So this was a rebellion against God, opposition against God, gathering together against God, people taking counsel together against God, and look at how God sees them. He will sit in the heaven. That is God shall do what? Shall laugh. Oh? But they are plotting against you, God. Alright? There are many and they have gathered together against you. But do you know what the Bible says? God laughs. He shall hold them in derision. In other words, he will scoff, he will mock them. In other words, God will say, that's useless. Alright? Now look at verse 5. And the Bible says, then he shall speak to them in his wrath and distress them in his indignation. So you see, even before God speak to them, before God deal with them, the Bible says he laughs at them. Can you imagine people coming together? You heard that people have gathered together against you. They have conspired against you and you are laughing. Do you know something? It means you have already seen the way God sees. That's the way God. Many of us, when the enemy shows up what is plotting against us in the dream, we wake up and we are panicking. What is wrong with you? That's not the way God sees things. Is somebody paying attention? Whatever the enemy is plotting, God sees it as vain, as useless, as useless. God laughs. God laughs. So if I begin to see as God sees, you know, things that make you cry, things that will make other people depressed, you will laugh at it. Alright? When you are and then there is a wall on the way, you don't just break down and weep like the rest of the people. You laugh. Do you know why? Because you know some of you are going over it. Is somebody paying attention? You are still moving forward. This wall cannot stop you.
Amen.
And you know this 2019, that's the way I want us to begin to see. And you know what? God is not the only one sitting in heaven. We are seated together in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
That's what the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians 2, 5 and 6. We have been raised together. We are seated together in heavenly places. That's what I'm saying. I'm sitting in the heavenly places. In Christ Jesus. And so, you know, there's no giant anywhere. Somebody pay attention. Because where you are higher. You are greater. You are greater than any adversary. And in this year 2019, I want you to know there's no giant anywhere that can stop you. You are the giant. Is somebody paying attention? In Christ Jesus, you are the giant. That's what I'm saying. I am the giant. That's what Joshua was saying. The other people said they are the giant. Joshua said they are blessed. We are the giant. We are the giant. Their defense has departed from them. God is with us. God is with us. This year 2019, I want you to know that God is with you. Are you listening to what I'm talking about? Now you see, those demons that we fear, if God opens your eyes and you see them, they are like hands, they are like that. They are not giant. The devil always wants you to think that he's giant. He's so strong, he's so powerful. But you know something? You are more than conqueror. You are stronger than any devil. You are stronger than any demon. You know, life challenges come and then you have a death and the death is piling up and the devil is telling you this is too much. This is more. You can't tackle this. You can't handle it. You can never survive. That is a lie. That is a lie. You are the blessed. You are the blessed. You are the blessed one of the Lord. And oh, I just wanted to declare tonight. I wanted to declare it is time for us to change our view. Alright? Now, many of us, the devil, we magnify the devil so much. Much more than God, much more than ourselves in Christ Jesus. Alright? Somebody better tell you, you are seated together with Christ in heavenly places. And it doesn't matter what shows up on this earth, you are greater, you are stronger than that. Let somebody say, I'm greater than all my enemies. There is nothing that comes against me that I'm not stronger than. When anything shows up, say, I am stronger than they. Maybe there's a symptom. There's a symptom that shows up in your body. Say, I am stronger than they. I have God's healing power. I have God's healing power. Oh, they said, this look like cancer. This, he said, I am stronger than that. Oh, they said, this is high blood pressure. I am stronger than that. Oh, we don't even know what it is. You are stronger.
You are stronger than that.
Joshua and Caleb say, we are stronger than the giant. This 2019, enough of seeing yourself as little, as small. Enough of seeing yourself as nobody. No, you are the giant in Christ Jesus. I just want you to open your mouth and begin to declare, I am strong in Christ Jesus. I am the giant in Christ Jesus. There is no giant anywhere. Nothing can stop me. Nothing can stand in my way. I am an overcomer, more than conqueror. I overcome every life challenges. I overcome every situation. There is nothing that will come against me this year that I will not overcome. There is no obstacle that can stop us. He said 2019, nothing stop us. He said 2019, nothing stop us. Nothing hold us back. Nothing hold us down. In the name of Jesus, we overcome in Christ. We overcome through Christ. We are the victors in Christ. We are more than conquerors. Whatever comes against us, we are more than it. Whatever rises against us, we are stronger than it. Whatever comes our way, we are bigger than it. We are bigger than all death. We are bigger than any situation. We are stronger than all adversary. We are greater than them all. We are greater than them all. Enough of being afraid what the enemy is plotting. Is somebody paying attention? Enough of being afraid. The Bible says your God says it is a vain thing. It is a vain thing. Someone paying attention? God laugh at it. The devil showed you something in the dream. This is what I'm going to do to you. I'm going to kill you. Just wake up in the morning. Even before you pray about it, just laugh at it. Just laugh at the devil. Because you know it is a vain thing. That is the winner perspective. That is the way the winner sees things. Is somebody paying attention? That is the way the winner sees something. That's the way the winner sees. Oh, they said something bad is going to happen to you. Just laugh at it and say, I am bigger than that. I am stronger than that. I am stronger than that. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Father, we just pray in the name of Jesus that this new year, Lord, we begin to see ourselves just as you see us. We begin to see through your lens, Father. We begin to see through the lens of the world. Lord, we will not see ourselves through our own lens, through the lens of order, through the lens of our past experiences, our past failures and disappointment. We refuse to see ourselves through the lens of the devil. We refuse to see ourselves through the lens of the enemies, Father. And Lord, we know there are no giants anywhere. We have the giant in Christ Jesus. Anything that comes against us is a grasshopper. Anything that comes against us is like an ant. Anything that comes against us is below our feet. We are raised together with Christ. We are seated in Christ in heavenly places. There is nothing that comes against us that is not under our feet. Whether it is sickness, it is under our feet. Whether it is devil, it is under our feet. Whether it is lack, it is under our feet. We are bigger than any man say. We are taller than any challenge of life. We are taller. All those that come against us, they are our bread. They are nothing before us. Father, we declare it, Lord, that when we look at our enemy, we don't see any giant. When we look at our enemy, we see just hand. When we look at enemy, we see men and women. We see devil and power. Whose strength has departed from them? Lord, when we stand before our enemy, we stand as more than conqueror. We stand as champion. We stand as overcomer. Jesus. Father, thank you. Help us, oh God, in this year to go with this consciousness, Father. To walk in this consciousness. To begin to see and think, Father. As you all know, we see and think in every situation. Thank you, Father. And let the people of God say loud, Amen. Glory be to God.
We hope you have been challenged, encouraged, and motivated to become more like Christ by today's teaching. If you would like to find out more about Eras of Revival and get additional teachings and materials for your healthy spiritual growth, visit our website today at www.erasofrevival.org. Or if you would like to enroll at our School of Discipleship, visit our website www.theschoolofdiscipleship.org.uk. This teaching was made possible by the prayers and generous free will offering, donation, and gifts from partners like you. You are welcome into partnership with us today. For information on how to become a partner, please call 1-868-292-9270 or 1-868-703-5572. Or you can email us at info@erasofrevival.org.uk. Thanks for listening.